Hey, Money Guy family, it's your host, Brian Preston, here with Mr. Bo Hansenwick, back with another episode of Ask the Money Guy.
That's right. You've got financial questions. We've got your financial answers. Go out to your favorite social, use the hashtag AskTheMoneyGuy, or you can go to our website, moneyguy.com, and ask us a question there.
It's Brian Preston, the Money Guy.
So today, Brian, today's question actually comes from some comments in the YouTube comment section. So if you go to any of our videos, there's always some comments on there. This one came out of there, and this is from Chris L.
We're going to be taking out a hater hate.
This is hater hate. Yep, got it.
Well, I could say he just comes out from his troll bridge.
Oh, there we go. There we go. So this is from Chris L. And he said that becoming a millionaire is a concept from the past, when the rings to the ladder were much lower. So his ultimate question is it harder to become a millionaire now than it was previously, or than it has been historically?
I feel like every character in every Disney film that's like, oh, I'm not going to be able to do it. I mean, that's what I felt like, because that was Chris.
Chris.
I mean, there's a lot of kaint.
Right.
You know, a lot of barriers just built into that glass half empty outlook. And that breaks my heart, because that's why I was excited when we got this question, because these stats, you just can't lie with
that's
the numbers.
Right.
And I broke this into two ways. I first wanted to kind of walk through history and some of the research on what percentage of millionaires are first generation, because
yep.
I think that's important. And then I wanted to compare, okay, well, if we know that there's a percentage of the population that becomes millionaires, is it increasing or is it decreasing?
Right.
So we tackle it from that side. So let's first talk about millionaires in general, because I think there's a lot of misconceptions. A lot of people out there think that millionaires are born, meaning that they got lucky,
inherited
that mommy
something. Yep.
And daddy were rich.
That's right.
I mean, I think I grew up in that.
Absolutely.
So, but that is not true. I thought Sarah put us on, Dr. Stanley's daughter, who wrote The Next Millionaire Next Door,
right.
put us on a research study from 1892 that showed that 84% of millionaires back in 1892, I was shocked to find out there were millionaires in 1892, 84% were first generation.
Meaning they built it from the ground up, starting at zero.
They didn't inherit it. It was there. They were the ones. They came from not much money to building a fortune.
That's right.
1996, Millionaire Next Door. Bo, show them the prop.
Boom. Millionaire Next Door.
This is the one that got it started for me. 1996, Dr. Thomas Stanley wrote this book. And he has the stat that 80% of millionaires are first generation.
So over 100 years later, and the number was 84% 100 years before 1996, and then it's 84% 1996.
So fast forward, unfortunately, Dr. Stanley has passed away, but Sarah, his daughter, has continued his legacy, and she updated a lot of his research in 2018 with The Next Millionaire Next Door. Bo's holding up the prop. And Sarah found out that, listen to this, 86% of millionaires, when she updated the data points, were millionaires that were first generation.
Unbelievable. So it seems very consistent through time that those that follow into millionaire status are between 80 to 90%.
And then I thought the last one, and then we'll cut off with the props, because I don't want to make Bo feel too much like Carrot Top or Vanna White. He is pretty. Is is that Chris
Hogan.
I hope
that was for Vanna White, not for Carrot Top.
Both. You know, good looking ginger.
All right,
so,
fair enough.
You know, Chris Hogan, who works for Ramsey Solutions, you know, Chris came out with a book this year, and he had the same thing. It was about 84% are first generation.
That's right.
2019 book. So you can see between 80 to 86% of millionaires throughout the last, from 1892 all the way through 2019, were first generation.
So of the folks that become millionaires, it seems like it's an awful lot of bootstrap folks. So, but that doesn't actually answer Chris L's question.
Yeah,
his question is it easier or harder? We just know that the same characteristic of people doing it themselves, building from the ground, stays true through time. But are there actually more, or is it easier to become or harder to become a millionaire these days?
So we wanted to set the table for this. So let's go back through. I love the idea of, because I thought it tied in nicely. Let's look at each of those age, you know, those periods.
Yep.
Starting in 1892 to see how many millionaires were there as a percentage of population, and is that number going up? So we can see, is Chris right with his glass half empty, that was a concept of the past back when the rungs to success were easier for you to climb?
Right. So in 1892, there were 4,047 millionaire households. So 4,047 millionaire households.
Out of how many?
Out of total U.S. population of 63 million. So if you do that in percentage terms, it's 0.006% of the population.
Not a lot of millionaires.
We're millionaires.
A millionaire, inflation adjusted.
Right.
That was more like multi-billion.
That's right.
But
that's
still,
right.
It's worth it. It's a concept to understand.
So now let's fast forward all the way up to 1996. Instead of only being 4,047 millionaire households, in 1997, there were 5.3 million millionaire households in the U.S. Total U.S. population in 1997, 270 million people.
Okay.
So now, if you look at the percentage, that's actually 1.96% of the U.S. population were millionaires.
Okay.
So it went from 0.006% up to 1.96%. So now, if we fast forward all the way up to 2018, in 2018, there were 11.8 million millionaire households in the U.S., and there are 327 million folks in the U.S. So if you look at the percentage again, that comes out to 3.6% wow. of the U.S. population.
So it came close, didn't double, but it came close, and that's moving rapidly. And I think the closer we get, that answers Chris's question, mm-hmm. is that instead of the rungs being pulled up because it's getting harder, I will tell you, I think the rungs have been dropped down.
That's right.
I think there's a lot more opportunity, especially with technology, the ability for you to invest without having to go to see somebody. Mm-hmm. There are so many opportunities now if you will just wake up, recognize, don't let somebody else define your kink, yep. and I use that right, is that don't let somebody be the negative Debbie Downer in your life. Just go and attack, guys. Go and do this thing. It's the best time to be alive if
That's
you
right.
want to build wealth, and I want you to go and tackle that. It's just an incredible goal, and you should do it.
If you have a question, you're curious about either some statistics or historical norms or trends or just anything in the financial world, and you have a question, go out to your favorite social, use the hashtag AskTheMoneyGuy, or you can go to our website, moneyguy.com, ask a question there, or you can get involved in the comments below. Leave us a comment. We read them all. We try to respond to a lot of them. We love having a conversation with you. We love being able to have that dialogue going. So stay engaged, stay involved, and we love hearing from you guys.
Money Guys out.